microwave thermal key and... Oh, for goodness sake, who is that clumping around outside?
Oh, it's just me.
Sergeant Benton, do you mind not making so much noise? It's very hard to concentrate.
Sorry, Doc. Nighttime security checks every hour on the hour. Briggs orders, sir.
Now listen here. I'm conducting a very important experiment in my laboratory there, and I'd appreciate it enormously if no one went in.
Right, okay, Doc.
Good man. Now, is the canteen open?
The canteen opens at 6.
What time is it now?
Coming on 3:30.
Good grief. It is late, isn't it? I don't suppose anyone else is about at this hour.
The night patrols are outside, and a few lads are asleep in the common room, I think. I did see the Brigadier was still in too.
Oh, splendid. If anyone can get the kitchen open, I suppose it's the man in charge. Right. In his office, is he?
I think he's in the library, Doc, I guess.
I didn't know Unit HQ had a library. Where is this library, then?
East wing, second floor, last door on the right.
Well, I think I'll just pop along and see him, then. Now, don't forget, no entry to anyone, right?
Right, sir.
Brigadier. Oh, my dear fellow. You kept this place to yourself? Very nice indeed. Bit too much oak for my liking, but what a delightful little hideaway you have here. Doctor.
What can I do for you?
Oh, nothing. I was at a natural place to pause the experiment I was working on.
And then you realised it was 3 a.m. Miss Grant had gone home hours ago and there was nobody about to make your tea.
What are you up to, anyway?
I was writing letters, actually.
Letters?
The next of kin of the men who died fighting the Dalek task force that attacked Reginald Starr's place.
I see.
7 of them. This week.
Yes. Well.
I like this room. It's private and it's comfortable. No interruptions.
Look, my dear fellow, I really had no idea.
The oak, the paintings, the books. All seem so very comforting. That's why I write the letters here.
It's very nice.
Do you know how many soldiers the British Army has lost since the Second World War? Up to the present day, I mean.
As a matter of fact, I don't. I do know that with humanity's propensity for self-destruction, that's 2,281. Up to last week, that is. Malaya, Korea, Aden, Suez, Northern Ireland, Cyprus. I see.
And you know which regiment has suffered the highest casualties in all that time?
No,
unit. I've had to write more letters of condolence than any regimental commander in recent history.
I see.
I don't think you do. They still come. They still volunteer.
And they're still heroes, aren't they?
To you, they're just clumping Neanderthals in heavy boots. Blunt instrument to be used when your finesse has failed. The way you talk to them. The ones who are baffled by your genius or overwhelmed by the situations they find themselves in. You'll find all their fears and misgivings as human stupidity and their professionalism and sacrifice as the narrow imagination of the... What do you keep calling it?
The military mind.
Well, I'm sorry, Doctor. I'm sorry my men aren't as brilliant as you or as cultured or as subtle. And I'm sorry they occasionally break the peace of your laboratory by training outside your window.
Training is how they improve their chances of not dying. Goodness knows they need all the help they can get. All right. I'll admit I'm occasionally a bit abrupt.
I know. You're an alien. Your values aren't the same as we tiny, primitive humans.
Brigadier, we've known each other a long time.
Yes. And yet you still didn't know about this room.
I see. Look, perhaps I should leave you to it. I'm sure you have a lot to do. But I do have one more thing to ask.
Oh, really?
Yes. When are you going to drop that ridiculous disguise?
So what gave me away?
Ah, that would be telling. You had me fooled for a while. All very convincing.
Indeed. You see, not only did I use the image of the Brigadier, I took thoughts and memories straight from his mind. His thoughts, his ideas. It really is the perfect disguise!
Now you listen to me.
Don't be concerned, Doctor. I was able to take a partial mind print from almost a mile away. A useful little device of my own invention. Always useful to know what humans are thinking, if at all possible.
How did you get the projection through? Materialize your TARDIS around the whole building or just this room?
Both myself and the room are a projection fed from my own TARDIS directly into where you felt safest.
I suppose as a disguise, as an improvement on wigs and rubber masks. May one be permitted to ask why you've gone to such effort?
A simple gesture of my will. I wanted you to know I can reach you at any time I please. From this point on, you will never really know if you are talking to one of your trusted friends or myself as a projection. I can discover your plans any time I like.
Oh dear me, you really are quite delusional, aren't you? You should know by now that I rarely make plans. Improvising is far more fun, don't you think?
Doesn't matter. I know that the process works.
You know, I wonder about that. Do you know what gave you away? You thought the Brigadier would use a room like this to write letters of condolence to the families of the men he lost?
You said it yourself. You had no idea.
Oh, but I did. I know very well that after every loss, he takes himself to a quiet place to write his letters. He does it in a room where he can see the trees and the sky. Where he can be reminded of the simple beauty of the planet his men die trying to save.
Doesn't matter. I can create any image I wish. Anyone you ever meet might be a spy. How will you ever wholly trust anyone again?
Well, that'll be a considerable nuisance. But I knew you'd try something like this at some point. Some attempt at penetrating Unit HQ with your own machine.
It is the first rule of war, Doctor. Attack whilst you have the element of surprise.
Which is why I switched the sensors of my own TARDIS on to detect any external pulses fed into this location. Now I know the precise frequency your TARDIS operates at. Mine can run interference. Oh, it won't block the images you try to send altogether, but it'll certainly give them a brightly coloured outline, like a cheap television effect. I doubt anyone would be fooled for long, do you?
Very clever.
First rule of war, protect your own headquarters.
There would seem little point in continuing this conversation.
Oh, really? And I was having such fun.
Incidentally, although I was an illusion, the words I used were taken directly from the mind of your friend. I genuinely think he might one day grow to truly despise you. With every uncontrolled outburst of arrogance, every callous remark, every fresh death, he may one day hate you as much as I do, and I would have had no part in it. Now, isn't that interesting?
Interesting indeed.
Good Lord, Doctor, what on earth are you doing here? I saw the light under the door. Were you talking to someone?
Oh no, just wool gathering. Happens when you get to my age.
That's quiet. Just some paperwork needs finishing off. Dalek business, you know.
And the men who died?
I like to try and add a personal note for the families, you know.
It was seven of them, I believe.
That's right.
I'm sorry. Truly.
Are you all right, Doctor?
Yes, fine. Look, you're busy. I'll leave you alone. Your men, they are heroes, you know. I think it's important that their families know that.
I'm afraid with security it's just not possible. But we know, don't we, Doctor?
Yes, we do. And we won't forget.
Good night, Doctor.
Good night, Alistair.